Manuel Rosa, professor at the Signature and Communication of the Department at the University of Alcalá. And I'm going to conclude with the presentation at the workshop related to the Scout project, talking about the Scout scientific and industrial exploitation. Now you have a general overview of the Scout project, and this is time to present some conclusions. During the project, we have been working about on dissemination of the project, the main characteristic, the main results, and now at the end we are working to present an exploitation plan that is going to be the last deliverable to be submitted to the European Commission. In this presentation I'm going to talk about the four carried out about dissemination and preliminary, not results, but thoughts about exploitation, the possible exploitation of the Scout project results. Okay, the outline of the presentation is this. I'm going to present a general overview of the project work packages, not the project itself, because at the end of the workshop you already have the idea of what is the Scout project. I'm going to pay attention to the main characteristics of a Scout, what is distinctive of this project, of the work that has been done in this project, and how it can be exploited in the future. I will talk about the dissemination exploitation activities, about dissemination, how we have maintained communication about the project during these last 3 years, and about the exploitation, I will talk about the possibilities, the different strategies, depending on the partners that are involved in Scout, about the possible intellectual property rights protection, and about the market, how to put the Scout project into the market, where we are now, and what is the roadmap to arrive to the market in the near future. Okay, this is the PERT diagram of the Scout project, the different work packages that have been carried out during these years. There are different technical work packages, from work package 2 to work package 7, with different issues about physical protection, risk analysis, cyber security, and so on. But there are two work packages that are transversal to the project, one related to management and another one about dissemination and exploitation. About dissemination, this work package 6 in the project, which deals about dissemination and exploitation activities, it was thought with three different tasks. The first one is the basic presentation and dissemination in the project. The main activity to be carried out in this task was the creation and maintenance of a website. This is the website of the project, scoutproject.eu, that you can consult if you want to have details about the project. We have been uploading papers, public deliverables, and information about the project continuously, and it's a good possibility to obtain more information about the Scout project. Okay, we have been carrying out synergies with related projects, and finally we have have been presenting results in international scientific and technological events, conferences, publication in journals and transactions, technical transactions, and of course the organization of this workshop is also part of the dissemination activities in this project. And finally, at the end, is at the bottom of the slide, we have to present an exploitation plan. There isn't a specific activity in the project for preparing this report, but it is a mandatory deliverable in the project. We are now working at this moment in the preparation of this last deliverable of the project. Okay, about dissemination and exploitation, the workload in the project was this, not too much. Almost all the partners were involved in dissemination, with the only exception of ASI, the Italian Space Agency, that was an end user in the project and hasn't technical activities at all. But the other partners were all involved in the dissemination and exploitation, and of course had responsibilities in preparing this last deliverable. Okay, this is a view of the project website. I recommend you to visit it. In the project, we present information. You can see here. Okay. General information about the project, the project overview, the partners, the methodology, results about publications, and there is also an intranet to be used by the project partners. This is the slide just to present some numbers about the dissemination in conferences and technical journals that is not completed, because I want to ask all the partners about the last papers presented and published in journals, but the last numbers I have are these. These are the activities carried out in the project and the reports we have submitted to the European Commission. At the beginning, we presented the dissemination plan. We have now to present the final dissemination report and then the exploitation study. And at the middle of the project, we presented a preliminary dissemination report. These are the numbers of papers, submitters, presented in conferences. Now we have presented nearly 40 conferences papers in the topics of cybersecurity, sensor development, sensor networks for critical infrastructure protection. Not all the results obtained in the project have been published, obviously, because some of them needs some kind of protection in order to allow the exploitation, but there are many, many results presented. There are 8 papers published in journals, in high quality journals in general, and there are several PhD theses under development in the different universities and research institutes that participate in the project. Okay, we are now in a workshop that was included in the proposal of the project, the possibility of organizing a workshop to present the scout results. This is the workshop at all. The project has presence in all the websites of the partners, companies, universities, research institutes. We have to prepare TV interviews at the end of the project to maximize the visibility of the results. And video is under preparation. Probably it will be uploaded to YouTube to maximize the visibility of the Scouts. Okay. Why do we want to maximize the visibility of the project? In order to maximize the possibilities of exploitation of the results. The European Community is funding a project with several millions of euros, and at the end, what is expected is to obtain results that can be put into the market. The possibilities of exploiting the results of a Scout are very high, that's very good results, but we need to increase the technological readiness level to arrive to the market. Okay, this is a graphic that the relationship between the risks and investment required to arrive to the market and the expected returns. The possibilities to exploit the resource can be just selling or licensing the intellectual property, to cooperate in research and development, to create a startup, or at the top, to develop and sell products and services. Depending of the partner, we are more interested in selling or licensing or just selling the products. Universities and research institutes are more interested in the possibility of selling licensing the intellectual property, because we cannot invest too much money to arrive to the market. And unfortunately, universities don't expect too much returns. But the companies that take part in the consortium, Hitrosiset, OESIA, should sell the products and services of Tynet in the project. Okay. These are the exploitation strategies of the main Scout outcomes. These are the main outcomes, not all of them, from the passive radar technology, the noise radar, KU band radar, the risk analysis tool that we haven't talked about it, but it's another product of the project, the different technologies, at the top, the technologies for physical security, at the bottom, the technologies for cyber security, and at the end, the classifiers and data fusion algorithms used that are not physical products, but algorithms and software. These are the partners that have been involved in these technologies, and these are probably the preferable exploitation strategy at this moment. Regarding these products, one of the very important points is the intellectual property rights protection. We should think about the possibility of patenting or obtaining the copyright of the different products. Patenting is interesting for technical functions, copyright is interesting for computer programs. The requirements are the novelty, the originality, and the protection time is different. Some of the results shouldn't be patented, because the problem with patents is that you give information that can be used by competitors. So sometimes it is better to maintain the secret about what we have done in order to exploit it. It is important, for example, regarding algorithms and special formulas that can be used in these algorithms to obtain the very good results we have got. In this final report, we are preparing, of course, a list of the main competitors we have in the market. It's just a short list. The list can be higher, of course. And we have carried out the effort to present a SWOT analysis. A SWOT analysis that relates the trends, the weakness, the opportunities, and the threats to arrive to the market. Regarding the strengths and the weakness of the products, you can more or less know what they are at the end of this presentation. But the opportunities to arrive to the market and the threats we have to face are important and must be taken into consideration. Regarding the opportunities, this market is related to security in critical infrastructure is growing up very quickly. There is a very big interest in the European community about the critical infrastructure protections. There is a program in the ACE 2020 program to develop these technologies, and the market is going to be very important in the near future. Fortunately, the market for physical security is concentrated. That means that there are not too much competitors compared to other markets, of course. And regarding threats, just to mention someone, the problem is that this system is very complex. There is a very wide range of capabilities needed that must be supported by all the partners. In order to put the Scout project into the market, we must know what the many legal issues that can vary from different countries. So, regarding this, there are some international markets with barriers of entry. And probably this system that is complex and probably the final results can be expensive. This is another barrier to entry due to the economical crisis in many European countries that can avoid to invest money to install these kind of systems for protecting critical infrastructure. It must be taken to decide if it's necessary. Okay. Almost to finish, I want to present at the end what is more or less the tier I achieved at the Scout project to know where we are and where should we be to arrive to the market. The different technologies have arrived to the tier L that is considered as pre-commercial, more or less 5-6. It means that the technologies have been proved in a relevant scenario, not in a real scenario. In a real scenario means that the system should be installed and proved when the scenario activity is working on to detect the threats, to recover in case of damage, and so on. We need to upgrade the capabilities of the Scout project to arrive at least to tier L 7, 8, 9, close to the market. The possibility to do this is to obtain more investment to improve the system. The main possibility that has been mentioned during the morning is to apply to follow on project and innovative actions probably in the call about critical infrastructure protection. Innovative actions implies that we must arrive to TRL 7, 8, 9 to put the product in the market. After this innovative action, we must be prepared to make commercialize the Scout project. Okay, these are some conclusions. I have mentioned the Scout system has been validated, it has reached to be classified as pre-commercial. Some investment is needed to upgrade the TRL and put the system into the market. The possible way to comply to the H2020 program about critical infrastructure protection, to use private investment to ride to the market. Probably a combination of both is the best solution. I have presented some results about scientific dissemination that have been carried out in the project. And at the end, I want to mention that the consortium has been aware of the importance of dissemination during the project to allow all the stakeholders to have the knowledge that the Scout system is under development, it can be commercialized in the future. And just to finish, I want to mention that the Scout project has been very innovative. As far as I know, it's the first system that combines physical protection and cybersecurity for critical infrastructure protection. This is the philosophy of the ACE2020 program about critical infrastructure protection. But we were innovative in this concept. So it is very important that this is probably the first system combining both physical security and cyber security. And what is very important, the Scout system has been designed for protecting critical infrastructure that is the ground segment of a satellite communication system, but can be used in almost any other kind of critical infrastructure. So the possibilities of commercializing are very high. Thank you very much, and we want to ask.